Well, during the rescue operations over the past few days, many on the scene had hoped to use underwater vehicles to help locate victims of the Sewol disaster, especially when divers themselves couldn't go into the water.
But strong tidal currents and limited visibility have made that very difficult. Our Park Ji-won tells us what technologies have accompanied the search efforts.
This is a remotely operated underwater vehicle called the Haemire, developed by the Korea Institute of Ocean Science and Technology. This unmanned vehicle can dive up to 6,000 meters to the bottom in the sea and move at a speed of about 2.8 kilometers per hour. This multifunctional deep submergence vehicle is equipped with robotic arms, a diverse set of measuring instruments, and an underwater camera. Some question whether this state-of-the-art unmanned underwater vehicle can provide any help in the ongoing rescue operations of the Sewol-ho ferry. However, experts say the vehicle was developed for the purpose of deep-sea exploration, where currents are not very strong.
The tidal current speeds near the Sewol accident site are about 8 kilometers per hour. The propulsion of the underwater vehicle needs to be at least twice that.
Another piece of equipment that could help is this so-called diving bell, which provides an air pocket where divers can breathe. Deployed near divers, it can lengthen the amount of time they can stay underwater.
Divers now have to wait for the currents to stop because strong tidal currents have been hampering their operations. This can be a shelter for divers, and divers can continue dives for 20 hours.
The establishment of systemic technology support by revamping remotely controlled submergence vehicles and innovative diving technology is ever the more urgent to save lives during maritime disasters. Park Ji-won, Arirang News.